بسم الله الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم. I am your chemistry teacher Faisal Omar, and today we are going to study hemolytic and heterolytic bond cleavage. Okay, we can also call it hemolytic or heterolytic bond fission and breakage as well. They all have same meaning. Okay, first of all, what do you know about hemo and hetero? What's the meaning of hemo and what's the meaning of hetero? If you know the answer, write in the comment section below. I will be waiting there for you. Okay, students, let's start. First of all, I have a question. What's a bond cleavage or what's a bond breakage? Okay, let's consider that we have a hydrogen molecule and there is a singular bond between them. This was known as sigma bond, as we have studied. The first covalent bond between two atoms was a sigma bond, and the next one, it goes double and triple, then it will become pi bond. This is a sigma bond. It's a very strong bond. Okay, so when this hydrogen wants to react, it's obvious that this bond should be break. Okay, so in this case, what happens if this bond should be break? As I told you that there are basically two kind of breakage or two kind of cleavage. The first one is the hemolytic cleavage and the second one is the heterolytic cleavage. Okay, as I told you, remember this, cleavage means breakage or fission, to break apart. Okay, so let's see what's the hemolytic cleavage. Let's study. In this type of bond breakage, the two electrons of nuclei or covalent bond that are shared equally, will be break apart and each atom will take its share of electron, which means that in the last one, as we have seen in hydrogen, each hydrogen will take its own electron. If you remember that, I have told you when a bond occurs, in this case, one electron from both sides takes share in covalent bonding. I am talking about the covalent bonding because hemolytic bond cleavage and the heterolytic bond cleavage are present in covalent bonding. It's not about the ionic bonding. So which means that from each side, one orbital which will have one electron, they take apart. And in hemolytic bond cleavage, when this bond breaks, each atom will take its share of electron. It's something like this. For example, you start a business with one of your friends and you share amount of money, and your friend shares also same amount of money, and you start business. And when you see that you cannot manage with your friend, you say that, give me my share, I am going to start a separate business. So you take your share and get out, and you get out of the business, and the next one, your friend does same thing. So hemolytic cleavage is something like this. And the next thing is that in hemolytic cleavage, radicals are formed. Okay, radicals are formed. What are the radical? Let me tell you. Radicals are the kind of atoms. Radicals are not ions. Radicals are atoms which have an empty orbital. Okay, they are very reactive, but they don't have any positive or negative charge, but they are still very reactive. For example, over here you can see A and B. There were two atoms. Okay, there was a bond between them. And when this bond was broken, when we break this bond, in this case, we know that one line represents two electrons. One bond represents two electrons. So A took his own pair and B took his, sorry, A took his own share of electron and B took his own share of electron. So A has one electron that was in this bond, and B has also his share of electron that was in this bond. Now these two atoms are very reactive. These are known as radicals. Radical could be a polyatomic or could be a diatomic or could be a monoatomic as well. Okay, so remember this thing. It's not an ion. In hemolytic cleavage, radicals are formed. In hemolytic cleavage, ions are not formed. And hemolytic fission takes place in the presence of ultraviolet rays or very high temperature, for example, in chlorination of methane as well. We know that chlorine has a single bond between two atoms of the chlorine. When they are broken, each of them can take their own electron. So in this case, they will turn to a chlorine radical. So that kind of bond cleavage or bond fission will be known as hemolytic bond cleavage. Okay, so then let's study what's the heterolytic bond cleavage. Heterolytic bond cleavage, in this kind of bond breakage or bond fission, one of the atom takes both of shared electrons. Okay, So let me give you an example. As I told you, you start a business with your partner, and you take your share back, and he takes his share back, and you start your business separately. That was an example of hemolytic bond cleavage. But in heterolytic bond cleavage, you start a business with your friend, and you share an amount of money. He share also amount of money, and now you are you cannot manage with your friend. You say that I don't want to stay with you, but he says that okay. You can go, but I will not give you a share because he is powerful. So this kind of breakage or cleavage or fission is known as heterolytic bond cleavage. Okay, and when it comes to the atoms, this type of fission takes place due to the presence of an electronegative atom in a species. This species could be a molecule. Okay, this electronegative atom inductively withdraw electrons in a nuclei. Okay, so as I told you that if one of you are powerful and he doesn't know nothing about justice, so he says that okay, I will also take your share, my share is also mine, you can go out, I will give you nothing. So this kind of breakage is heterolytic breakage. For example, two atoms are combined with each other, one of them is electronegative, other is electropositive. We have studied electronegativity and electropositivity. The electronegative atom pulls the electron and it doesn't allow the other one to take the electron. So when they are broken apart, electronegative one will get negative charge because he has an extra electron, and the electropositive one will get a positive charge because he has a less amount of electron. So this kind of breakage or this kind of fission forms ions. Let's see over here. There are two atoms A and B, okay? So what happens when this bond is broken in the heterolytic cleavage? You see that A atom has lost its electron and B got an electron. So A has become a positive ion or cation, and B has become a negative ion or anion. Now A is electrophile. Electrophile means it likes electron because it needs electron. And now B is nucleophile. Nucleophile means it likes nucleus because it has an extra minus charge or extra electron. Okay, let's work upon example, and I want you to guess which one of them is hemolytic breakage and which one of them is heterolytic breakage. Okay, students, guess. I am waiting. I give you 5 seconds. Just pause the video and answer me. Which one of them? The first one or second one? Which one of them is hemolytic breakage and which one of them is heterolytic breakage? Okay, I am waiting. Okay, let me tell you the answer. The first one is hemolytic breakage because chlorine and chlorine, when they broke apart, each one of them has taken his own share of electron. This one was made up of 2 electrons, this bond. So you can see this chlorine took 1 electron, this chlorine took 1 electron. So this is a hemolytic breakage. They are equal. And over here in this one, in HCl, in hydrogen chloride, chlorine took both of the shared electrons, and now hydrogen is empty of the electron. It has a totally empty orbital, and chlorine has 1 extra electron. You can see it is a positive ion and this is a negative ion. Okay, students, I hope you have learned what's hemolytic and heterolytic bond cleavage. And still, if you have any question, you can write in the comment section below. See you next time. Goodbye.